Well, the reality is codependents are paradoxically strong and fragile. They have to do everything for everyone else and do nothing for or do little for themselves. And I'll tell you something. It takes a strong person to kind of take care of everyone else's stuff while ignoring your own. But the fragility is hidden. They have this salt of the earth profile. Everyone thinks they're great people, they're admired, they're loved, they're venerated, but yet they suffer. To understand the human magnet syndrome, you have to understand that there are unconscious elements at play. And I'll never forget the time where a therapist said to me, you know, Ross, the problem with you is you have a broken picker. You're always picking the wrong person. And that, I figured it out. It's not them, it's me. If there was something wrong with, of course, my fingers actually don't do that. That's Photoshop. But there was something wrong with me. Because I can't solve the narcissist, but I can solve me. And if I'm always dancing with the wrong person and always choosing the wrong person, how can I solve the problem just by stopping it? I had to figure out, why am I picking the wrong person? The same friend said to me, and this friend was very judgmental, and he used to get me really angry, but he was always right. I had the broken picker. He also said, I was falling in love with the same woman, but always had a different face. And I'll never forget when he said that. And I go, you're right. I mean, she is a little bit that way, and she's a little bit that way, but they all had some form of pathological narcissism. And he said, until you figure, and this really annoyed the crap out of me, until you figure out why you're falling in love with the same woman with a different face, you're going to have the problem. I'm going, really? Can't you just, like, tell me what to do? And it was the understanding of the codependent dance that I was able to finally get to the problem that led me to the creation of the human magnet syndrome.